Hey everybody, it's your girl Bunny. To all of my returning subscribers, hey, how you doing? And for those of you who are new to the channel, welcome. Kick your feet up, subscribe to this family-friendly channel, and don't forget to click the notification bell so you don't miss any posts. Also follow me on Instagram at the same profile name so you don't miss the sneak peeks of what's coming up next. In this video, we have from It Dress Wig FFC201 in 4 different colors. I'll show you how they look, how they feel, my ordering process, and everything else. Let's get straight to it. I wanted to film everything immediately when I got the box. The only thing that I did was I got a black marker just to cross out anything for the safety of myself in the video. But I am just getting scissors, opening the box, and I can see that it's well packaged. They also have a return slip right at the top, so if you don't like what you have, you can return it. And all of the boxes are neatly stacked in there, so I'm just gonna pull them out one by one. And it's awesome that they're not just in a bag, they are in these nice boxes that you can store your wigs back in. And I'm noticing that it's confirming that each wig is heat safe to 400 degrees. Now, I wouldn't go all the way up to 400. I would keep it safe to about 370 because these are synthetic wigs. So I got that together. Now you can see the labeling here that they're heat safe, and I'm just gonna take each one out just to see if there are any smells. There is a card here that gives you information about how to take care of your wig, how to wash it, curling recommendations, what to use, when to washing it, etc. And I noticed that the wig is neatly packaged. I got these wigs for about $28 each, and they're on sale now. There isn't any lace. This is a full cap. There are 2 combs in the front, 1 comb in the back. And what I notice on the side is there's this non-slip grip that's on the sides of the wig, because sometimes when it's a full cap, just having hairpins doesn't keep it intact. Also, there is a skin-like top, and it's not this straight part, it's kind of zigzag, which makes it look more realistic, which is great. And that's just amazing, you guys. Just to give you an idea, they have 16 colors and I only got 4. So if you guys want to check this out, be my guest. Here is what it will look like when you go on the website. Now let's start with Miss 1B. So I just literally just plopped this on my head and I'm like, wait a minute, hold up. I didn't do anything. I don't have a comb near me, nothing. This is the 1B. It has this yakky shine kind of to it. It's silky, but not like this silky doll-like texture. This slight bob at the end. But if you want to flat iron that out and you want to have it bone straight, you can at the ends. But this slight bump at the end gives it a little bit more realistic look, kind of like a nice silk press on some permed hair. That's the feeling of it. Make sure that you can push back the bangs. It's recommended like right under the eyebrows, just a little bit, but I don't mind it touching the top of my lashes because it looks a little bit more chic to me. But I'm just getting the combs and I'm kind of getting them off of my hair because I don't use the combs, I use hairpins. But I'm just showing you for display purposes how it looks. And as you can see, there's this lifelike material at the top, but it's not like this white lifelike thing. It's like a skin look, and I'm just pulling this up just to my hairline and pinning it on the side, not your edges, because we want to keep our edges. And that made it look so much more realistic because the inside, the in area, has that weft that's folded over, so there's not this harsh line. And I'm like, wait a minute, I'm putting this up and just pulling out a little thin layer on the side, a few strands on the side, just to cover up where that weft bends. Now I have on a nude stocking cap, okay, and I'm putting that on a little ponytail. Like I don't have a comb, I'm not even trying to do this neat, okay. And it's just looking great. It's just looking like I got a perm or something, and I got a shortcut and I'm putting half of it up and the rest down. I would recommend that you put a black stocking cap underneath this, so if you do pull it up, you don't see the new stocking cap. And I'm just like, wait a minute, this reminds me of the 90s, you know, when you just had this little you know, a little coof look. You got a wrap and you just got your bangs cut. But you can just throw this into a quick ponytail, wrap that. Look, I'm not even trying. I'm like, wait a minute. I'm not even trying. And when I turn my head, you can see that nude stocking cap. If you wore black, you wouldn't be able to see it. But of course, you want to make sure that the wefts are covered. I did experience some shedding. You guys, this is a synthetic wig. You will have shedding, okay? So I'm just showing you there, when I'm running my fingers through it, I do receive shedding when I kind of comb through it. And I'm like, wait a minute, y'all know I'm from Dallas, Texas. So that I got to put my hat on there just to see how it looks with a hat. And I like it. It's crack-a-lackin'. Y'all, I'm just throwing this on my head because I got four other colors to film. But I'm just showing you, I just plop that on my head. We got an emergency. Plop that on to the next wig. The next color is 4N274. Now, many of you might not like this color, but it's different. You know, I don't like to stay using the same colors. It has this orange hue to it, slash yellow, slash little hints of blonde hairs that are in it. It's like a mix. It's a good mix. It's not like this solid color where it's just like, you know, it looks like a Halloween wig, but there's nice colors blended in the sunlight. It looks really, really good. So this is a nice color. And I also wanted to show what it would look like if I just threw it up again into a nice little bun at the top. As you can see, that lifelike part at the top. I like this color. I've never had this color before, but I wanted to get something that was different. But I'm showing you, if I just put it up in a quick little ponytail, that will look good. You don't have to wear it in a bun. But this was different for me. As you can tell, the energy on my face, I'm like, I don't know, child. But you know how you wear a color more, you start to feel it a little bit more. I'm pretty sure if I wore a different color shirt, that it would look much better, that color would pop. But it looks good. The more I'm wearing it, I'm like, you know what, I really like this color. It's different for me. I probably would have wore a different color lipstick, you know, just to get used to it. But I'm loving this color, y'all. Let me know what you think. If you're like, girl, no, that's not the business, let me know that. But I'm just showing y'all how these colors look against my skin. I'm a dark skinned sister, and if you see it online and you were wondering about the color, at least you can see it on my head and be like, girl, that ain't it, or that ain't it for me. If you like this color, then you in business. Once again, that texture is like a nice yakky feel, as if somebody, you had a perm and you got it cut. I'm also kind of showing you that you can taper this wig more to your face. And I'm like, this is looking sloppy how I'm putting the bun up. I don't have my comb with me or nothing. Let me take this down. Right here, I'm just kind of playing with it just to see, you know, I wonder, could I put this in a middle part? Just kind of play with it. And just off the top, it didn't. I'm pretty sure if you pull your edges out, but there's this demarcation there. I'm pretty sure if you pull some edges out and it matches this color, then you could kind of wear it with the little fluff, maybe curl it a little bit to go that way. But it's really not flowing with that wig. Not really. So put that is more of a bang yang, okay? But I was just curious. So I don't want to waste your time. Let's move on to the next wig. Now we are moving on to the 99J. Now this has some color, a little bit of maroon color, but it's really subtle. So subtle that you can barely see the difference. So I entered in a color here in the sunlight so you can see it, okay? That's the color that we're working with. Subtle, something appropriate to wear to work. It's not this bright red. And I'm just showing kind of, if you just pull up some hair, you could throw it up in a messy bun. Y'all, I'm just showing y'all real quick. You know what I'm saying? Just real quick to give you an idea. Look, I don't even have a comb. I'm not even making it perfect. And I could just throw that in a quick bun. This texture seems a little bit more of a yakky feel. I'm guessing because of the color that they've added to the synthetic fibers, but I love it. And since I have on this maroon shirt, maybe the contrast is not popping as much. I was showing my black roots there, that since I have this color, just get a hairpin or make sure that your combs are closer to cover your black roots. On to the next wig. Now I know what you're thinking, my dark-skinned sisters. I know what you're thinking. Uh-oh, she pulling out the 613. No, she pulling out the 613. It's not for me. Look, I'm gonna need you to step out of your comfort zone and give this a try. And look, if you order this wig and you don't like it, I have posted a video below of how to dye a synthetic wig if the 613 is too much, okay? Now look, don't be scared. Don't be scared of this color. Don't be scared, y'all. Now look. With dark skin, to me, the 613 just pops, okay? It pops off the skin. Make sure to get you either a nude wig cap or a wig cap that's closer to your skin tone, because a black under that will just show very badly, okay? So I'm just grabbing some of this hair just to make a little quick bun real quick. Just a real quick bun. Just a wick. If you're not feeling it, it's okay, sis. I'm just showing you. I took a chance because I ordered another wig that was in 613 and it was long, but for some reason it just wasn't popping, and I dyed it a brown color and even took it to a next level with a lavender. I put that video down below, but I'm just showing you, if I just throw that into a quick bun, like, it's falling apart, okay? I was like, wait a minute, hold up. Let me try one more time. Because I'm like, I'm just grabbing stuff. But if I just grab this, all right, I'm just really loving this 613. I feel 613, if it's a wig that's in a cut or a style that's not too much, when it's this color, it's not as out there, if that makes any sense. But I'm just throwing in the quick bun. Make sure you get you a brown or a nude color scrunchie and not black. That way it'll be easier for you to cover up. But I'm just showing you how I could just, I'm not even trying, I'm just throwing it up just to give you an idea of the things that you could do, okay, and to putting this in a bun. And I'm digging it. I'm not even perfecting it. I'm just loving the color. It's so different. I'm just grabbing a hairpin real fast just to give you an idea of how it might look. It's not perfect. I don't even have all the hair up there. It look a hot mess, but I'm just showing you the color. I love the color. Okay, let me take this down. What you could do in the future is actually cut this wig at an angle. You can make a nice angle bob. And I think in the future, the longer I have it, if they get a little ragged and snazzy, I'm just going to give me a hair clipper and just cut it in this nice angle bob so it can be just super duper popping. But I love it. You know, I'm putting on the hat just to show you how it pops against that black. If you just want a little peekaboo of this 613, sis, you can rock that. Come on. Okay, let me take that off. But I took the wig off, and it's nice to know that when you're done after styling it or putting it however you want, that they go in these nice neat boxes. If you do go on the website and you pick colors that I have not reviewed, please feel free to mention in the comments, hey, Official Bunny rock these colors, check these out, while you rock and display the other colors, so we can kind of work as a team. Because it's nothing like wasting your money getting a wig and you're looking at the stock card color online and you get it and you're like, this is not what I wanted. Like, what? Oh my gosh, I just wasted my money. And y'all know it's a headache trying to send wigs back because they just like, oh, did you have it on your head? You can't get a refund. You don't want to deal with all that headache, okay? So that's why I just got all these colors, not only from my own curiosity, but just to fulfill yours, just in case you were wondering how it looked. I recommend this wig. It's a nice get up and go wig, good quality for an awesome price. I do have the website details where you can click on that and order your wigs to have fun. This is a nice fall wig, and you can rock it in the summer if you put out a little bit of your natural hair and have it blend a little bit more just to evade the heat. But I love you guys. Subscribe, click that like button and the notification bell so you don't miss any posts. Until next time, you guys, stay ready. I will post the Ready to Love episode 4 tonight. So that's coming up tonight. All right. So get ready. We also got Iyanla Fix My Life that comes on tomorrow, Saturday. So you can look at that, the recap and the review. Until next time, bye.